Jobs will be slashed, taxes increased, and first home buyers targeted as part of the O'Farrell government's first budget aimed at cutting costs.
Political reporter Josh Murphy joins us now from State Parliament. Josh, despite all the savings, we are back in the red and deep.
Well, Bill, for months we've been hearing how dire the budget situation is, and now we can reveal just how bad. The first spending blueprint of the O'Farrell government will plunge the state into negative territory. Now, here's a snapshot of what the situation is. There will be a deficit of $718 million, but that comes with a promise of a return to surplus by next financial year. Now, that position won't come without pain, and bearing the brunt of that will be first home buyers. Young people buying their first property will now not be exempt from paying stamp duty, and that could add thousands to the cost of young people buying their first dream purchase.
The Treasurer had warned his first budget would deliver tough love in a hope to stimulate the housing market. Mike Baird has stung first home buyers. On top of saving a deposit, soon many will need to pay stamp duty.
Certainly in the city it's extremely difficult to purchase a house, particularly for young people.
We'll see people borrowing more money. This will basically mean that first home buyers will have to borrow an additional $17,000 or $18,000.
Currently, first home buyers escape paying duty on properties worth less than $500,000, saving themselves up to $18,000. But from January, existing homes will no longer attract the discount.
We recognise this is a difficult decision, but we believe it is necessary to make buying a new home relatively more attractive than buying an existing dwelling.
The goal is to reinvigorate construction.
For every $1 million of construction expenditure, there's a further $2.9 million of output that goes into the economy.
These are the scenes the government is desperate to see. By the end of this year, 37,500 new houses and apartments would have been built. That may sound like quite a lot, but in fact it's the second worst construction result in 20 years. The change will save the state hundreds of millions of dollars each year, more than $1 billion by 2015. And according to one industry body, it may end up actually driving down property prices.
We actually think the policy wasn't working before, and that this reform will make housing more affordable by boosting the new housing supply.
Lachlan Kennedy, 10 News.
Now, it's not only first home buyers affected. There'll be tax increases and savage cuts to government spending. Now, a key part to that is thousands of public sector workers will lose their jobs in a shake-up that's intended to cut costs and pay for election promises.
This was the Premier before the election at Ten Studios, where he gave what many thought was a guarantee that public sector jobs were secure.
So the public servants are safe?
Public servant, look, we will need more public servants, not fewer.
But his first spending blueprint shows otherwise. 5,000 voluntary redundancies will be offered across government, with the potential for more to follow. Agencies will be required to slash $6 billion in spending over 4 years. Plus, an audit of government programs will cut $800 million.
Governments that lose control of their budgets lose control of their destiny.
But the destiny of many so-called backroom government employees is now uncertain.
We can see somewhere between 5 and 10,000 jobs going in the New South Wales public sector over the coming years.
These are people, in many cases, who voted for Barry O'Farrell.
Coal mining enterprises will also be hit. Royalties taken by the coalition will jump by $2 billion in compensation, it claims, for the impost of Federal Labor's carbon tax.
Then that will simply mean less money for infrastructure in places like New South Wales.
Treasurer Baird's making no apologies for the cash grab.
Today is not a day that I come and hand out chocolates and champagne.
But he will offload another public asset, with revelations Port Botany is now up for lease, and it could reap the government up to $2.6 billion. That and the billions in other savings are intended for the major road and rail projects the coalition was elected to build.
This government, this state, will live within its means.
Hard medicine for what voters hope is a good cure. Josh Murphy, 10 News.